Welcome to Conversations Live. For more than a decade, we've brought you the best in books, entertainment, and current events. When the movers and shakers of the world have something to say to you, they say it to us first. And now, celebrating 15 years of broadcasting, here's your host, Cyrus Webb.
And welcome back, everyone, to Conversations Live. I'm your host, Cyrus Webb. Glad you all could join us once again. Whether you're tuning in on the radio dial here in Mississippi at WYAD 94.1 FM, we're glad you all could be with us. Also, those joining us online through WYADonline.com or through our podcast, we're glad you all could be with us as well. We're excited to welcome Auny Bee to our program today. Auny is someone who's been able to take her own love for designing and creating and being able to not only pursue a goal that she had for herself, but also to see the amazing response to that. I had a chance to see some of her work on Facebook. We'll talk to her about that. We also will talk to Auny about how she's been able to get over the challenges that any creative may have when it comes to pursuing their goals and dreams, and also what you guys can look forward to her from 2019. Auny, hello to you, and welcome to the program.
Hi, Cyrus. Thank you for having me.
Hey, the pleasure is definitely all mine. So, Auny, so let's talk about this experience. I mean, I think, you know, regardless of where people might, you know, live in the world, you know, I think we all kind of know what it's like to have an idea to do something or want to do something. What has it been like for you, Auny, to be able to say that, you know, designing and creating is something I want to do, and then to be able to pursue that?
For me, it's definitely been a blessing. My biggest blessings is having the support system behind me, especially my mom. I have so many friends that may have parents that will say, you know, there's no money in public relations, or there's no money in designing, there's no money in this. You need to go and get you a steady job. You need to do this. You need to work and have steady income. And while I do have a day job, I've been blessed to have a mom that's been inspiring me and pushing me on a daily basis to pursue my dream when it comes to fashion. And so it's been a great journey so far, and she's been, if not probably my biggest blessing, just having her in my corner.
Right. And I think the support system, Auny, is definitely important. I think regardless of what you want to do, but also no matter where you're from, you know, I'm also from Mississippi, so I know what it's like to, you know, have people say, well, you know, nobody from Mississippi does X, Y, or Z, or, you know, you can't do that being from a certain place. How did you get over that? Because I think there will be people, whether they mean well or not, will say, you can't do that just because of where you're from or where you live. I mean, how did you get over that belief system?
Well, I've always been one to do my own thing, go follow my own rules. I've never been one to conform or do what everyone else is doing. And so it wasn't really hard. I will say that in the process, I did have those doubts and those fears, like, okay, what if people don't accept my store? What if they don't like it? You know, what if they talk about me behind my back? Or what if I don't meet their expectations? But I just had to stop worrying about that and, again, do my own thing, not worry about the naysayers or the doubters, and just go for it. Pray, set my goals, and put my plan into action.
Right. And I think the planning, I'm glad you mentioned that, because that, I think, is so important. I think a lot of times people will look at what others are doing and say, hey, I want to do that, but they don't always think about the work that goes in. Have you always known that committing to the work was something, Auny, that you didn't mind doing if it was a goal you wanted to reach?
No, because that was one of the things that kind of made me hesitant at first, because I knew that once I started this, I would have to commit to it on a daily basis. I would have to leave my day job, and from my day job, I would have to commit to my store. And even sometimes during the day, I would have to commit to my store during the day, so that I knew that it would be a lot, and I wasn't sure that that was something I would want to take on. But at the same time, time waits for no one. So it's like it's either now or never. Stop stalling, stop procrastinating, just do it. Just do it. You spend all these hours giving your time to these businesses, these other companies, and not your own goals. So I had to just let that go and put that same amount of work, but work 10 times harder for my own business.
Yeah. then that's it. And knowing that your own business is worth it, I think that's the other thing, putting that much effort into something for yourself, just as you would be passionate about something for someone else. I want to say for those who are just tuning in, it's on the radio side or online, you're listening to Conversations Live. We're excited to welcome Auny Bee to our program today. Auny is someone who's been able to set goals for herself, to achieve those goals, and then, of course, to see the hard work paying off. And, you know, I think, you know, when it comes to fashion, Auny, I think this is going to be of interest to a lot of people out there, because what I saw that our mutual friend, Mr. Joseph Thomas, tagged me in was you're actually being able to see your work literally on display. I mean, what is it like for you to have been, you know, to have a vision for a project, to work with someone to kind of see it being done, and then to see other people being able to enjoy it?
It's been life-changing. It's been a great experience. I've always had people tell me, I love your style. I love the way you dress, the way you put things together. And to actually create a platform where I'm able to go and pick out the clothes, now start designing some of my own pieces to present them to the world, to sell them and have people accept them, it's been an amazing feeling. I'm so grateful. I'm so blessed to be able to do it. It's been awesome.
Yeah. I think that's it. Could you have imagined, Auny, that in the process, because this has been a cool thing for me, that in the process of doing what you love and doing something that you're passionate about, that you might inspire other people along the way? Is that something that you thought about as you were kind of beginning the journey?
Yes, definitely. That's one thing I'm always conscious of when I am putting something out there, whether it's content on social media or the way that I carry myself, because I know that there are people watching me, whether they're my age, younger or older. I definitely want to be some sort of inspiration and, you know, encourage people to do it, whatever it is, to do it, to go for it and to keep going. No, it's not always going to be easy. It's not always going to be, you know, unicorns and rainbows. You will have those bumps in the road. But even when you reach those bumps, you have to just keep on going. If those hashtags that you're putting out there are not bringing in the right followers and the right shoppers, then you have to switch it up. Find a different hashtag that works. Find different content. See what works for your audience. But you have to keep on going. You can't be easily discouraged.
Right. Now, you were just talking about hashtags, Auny, so that brings up then social media. I mean, that is the way that a lot of people do stay connected online. It's a lot of way that people share what they're involved in. How important did you know social media was going to be in building your brand?
I knew that social media was going to be extremely important. Social media is how people are getting their businesses out there nowadays. That is how people are finding me, people that I don't know all over the world. That's how they found me, via social media, via the hashtags that I put out there. One of my first sales was from someone over in Africa. How they found me, I don't know. I know that it was from the hashtags, but social media is the way you set up your platform, the hashtags that you put out there, the content that you're putting out there. You have to be consistent with it, putting that information out there on a daily basis, whether it's new item, an old item, a new post, a new quote, whatever your business may be, you just have to keep on putting that content out there and staying relevant, because everybody's putting stuff on social media, but you want to make sure that you stay relevant in the midst of it all. Social media is very important, especially to reach those outside of the cities and the countries that you're in.
Right. Very good point. And we're going to be letting our audience know how they can stay connected with you when it comes to social media as well. Auny, so Auny, we have to talk about courage and fear, because it's one of the themes that we've kind of had on Conversations Live, the radio show, definitely for our audience here in the Yazoo City area, and also, you know, throughout the country and around the world. We try to remind people that, you know, I think it's a common thing to be afraid when it comes to trying something. I think it's a common thing to wonder what's going to happen. How have you not allowed the fear of how people would accept you or accept your work, how have you not allowed that to stop you?
Just constantly pray, keep going, just, you know, avoid negativity, stay positive, just, again, know that there will be bumps in the road, and not run from those bumps in the road, but turn those negatives into positive. If I have an item and I realize it's not selling, then it's like trial and error. Things will happen. How can I combat that? How can I go around it? Okay, this didn't work for my audience. Let me try something else. But I can't let that fear and the fear of something not working stop me, because if you let that fear consume you, then you would never be able to get ahead, or you'll never be able to progress because you'll be stuck in that fear. And that fear would kind of keep you behind. You have to kind of surpass that, get over that fear, and just keep on going. Try different avenues, try different things, but go past the fear of what if it doesn't work, what if someone doesn't like it, or, you know, the what ifs. You just can't let the what ifs consume you. You just got to be able to keep on going. You need to pray about it, meditate on, you know, whatever it is you do, but you have to be able to get up and keep on going.
Yeah. I think that's it. I think that's a great reminder for all of us. So let's talk about the what's next for you, Auny. I mean, as you kind of look at 2019, I mean, what are you looking forward to when it comes to yourself and your brand this year?
As far as myself and my brand, I want to make it bigger. Last year I got a chance to learn my audience, learn what it is that they're like, that they like, what it is that they don't like. But I want to do bigger things this year. I am working with the manufacturer to design more of my own pieces. So I not only want to be Auntie or Auny Bee, the boutique owner, but I want to be Auny Bee, the designer as well. So that's what I'm working on this year, designing my own Fold by Auny Bee pieces, presenting them to the world. And I just want to watch it grow.
Yeah. One thing that's on your website, shopboldbyaunibee.com, and we're going to remind our audience of that. I thought this was an interesting thing, the phrase, embrace the freedom to be your most fashionable and authentic self. You know, I think authenticity is not the easiest thing, especially when everyone's trying to be the next X, Y, or Z. How has that served you well, though, in business and in life, and not trying to be like someone else, but to be the best you that you can be?
I always like to be true to myself, whatever it is. I know that sometimes my fashion statement may be kind of out there or a lot different than what, you know, other people do or other people expect, but you have to be true to yourself. I don't want to be that boutique owner that has the same pieces that other boutique owners have. I want to be that boutique that has those statement pieces that people can go to and know that they can find something different and know that they can find a piece that speaks to them or speaks to what they're trying to do. So I think it's very important just to remain true to yourself, not to try to go with what the crowd is doing and not try to be someone else, because you can try to do what someone else is doing, but you'll never be able to do it exactly like them. You'll never be able to, you know, be like them. I can put on the same outfit that another young lady is wearing, but we're going to wear it different. We're going to look different in it. We may, you know, walk in the same room, but our confidence level may be different. You know, whatever the case may be, we just may carry ourselves in a different manner. So whatever you do, you just have to be true to yourself and what you're doing, the way you carry yourself, and the message that you're presenting to people. You just always have to be true to you.
That's it. I think that is so true. The authenticity definitely comes through. And people can tell, right? I mean, people can tell when you are not being who you were meant to be and if you're trying to be someone else. I mean, you know, that saying, real recognizes real, is so true. And I think that's one of the big things. Probably sounds different when I say it. But anyway, the people get the point.
it's true, though. Real does recognize real. You can tell if someone's not being their true selves or if they're not comfortable in their own skin. You just have to be true to yourself. If something doesn't work for you, then do what works for you. You can't do what works for someone else, because it won't work for you. It just won't.
That's right. That's exactly. Again, everyone, Auny Bee has been our guest. Great conversation with you, Auny. We've been talking with her not only about the journey of being able to do work that she loves, but also what it's been like for her to get the support that she has, to be a source of inspiration for others, and of course, as she looks ahead, what you guys can expect. So, Auny, I mentioned the website earlier. Let our audience know how they can stay connected with you.
Okay, you can stay connected with me. My social media platforms, both Facebook and Instagram, are Shop Bold by Auny Bee. So that's Shop, S-H-O-P, Bold, B-O-L-D, by Auny, A-U-N-Y-B-E-E. I know it's long, but it's Shop Bold by Auny Bee. And my website is www.shopboldbyaunybee. If you have any questions or anything, please feel free to comment under a picture. Shoot me a DM. I promise I'll respond.
All right. Well, Auny, thank you so much again for the time. Really appreciate it, and looking forward to our next conversation together.
Thank you for having me.
Hey, the pleasure is definitely all mine. And we thank your audience for tuning in to another great segment of Conversations Live.